flop, at Twitter, hashtag DFAFD. Don't flop all fucking days. The final battle of day one. We're 6 years old today. Who's in the fucking building? Hashtag, I haven't just developed Tony D's accent. I was going to say at don't flop, but I said hashtag and they blended together and became hashtag. You know, it was fucking good. All right, we're here. It's the main event of day number one. We just got out of that Kruger vs DNA, absolute classic. Shout out to them too. Final battle of the day. Let's get straight into it. You go. If you want to hit me on Twitter, Instagram, any of the things, the links are on the screen. If you want to hit don't flop as well, please get in touch. It's all good. We are 6 years old today. It's our sixth birthday annual event, November 2014 in Leeds. All right, MCs on my right hand side from the city we're in. They are contenders for the title. Please show some fucking love for Dialect and Zen! Yes, alright. Shouts out Dialect and Zen every time. And the final team I'm introducing of day one, show them love, the current tag champions from Don't Flop Sound. Thanks for the noise, show them team of fucking reminiscent mood of it. I'm talking about Don't Flop South and Don't Flop North, you know what I mean? It's all fucking love. Alright, shout out Shuffle, Milo, Dialect and Zen. Who won the flip? Again, I have no idea.
No, they're contenders. They go first.
Is that the rules, right?
Yeah.
You know, Bangle makes all the rules now, because I don't even fucking care. Alright, fine. They're the contenders, so they go first, and everybody can show some respect and quiet down. It's round number one on Dialect and Zen. Let's go.
Alright. You guys ready, yeah? Well, Marlon and Shuffle are so
gassed.
I mean, I heard in their house they've got 84 straps. I mean, Marlon's known for what his mates call trap. He's the type to break your door latch and take your stash, and he got that bloody great bald patch from wearing so many baseball caps.
Shuffle teeth? Ha!
Yeah.
Shuffle teeth are all black. And whenever you miss, the next day you won't even call back.
Sarcasm, a large pattern in your act.
So fall back, because we know who the champions are. Who are two geeks to a few MCs that have mastered the art? We move ravenous dark. A big shank will split your family in half. So after I leave your mum for dead blood, you can watch your uncle fester in Adam's family's yard.
We brought actual bars. So you might be able to challenge me when it comes to battling stuff, but in reality, you can't stop yourself getting stabbed in the park with a sarcastic remark.
So believe it or not, these two ain't really a prop. This is two peas in a pod versus two bees from the block. But if we're the ones who burst guns, supply weed in the rocks, for the title, why the fuck's my rival supplying me with a shot? You see, way back in the day, my dad used to be a pastor preacher for God. But Jesus or not, you two ain't got us nailed with them verses, because we ain't easily crossed.
You look like you drink tea from a pot. You know, with like a couple of scones. Be us, you and who? You only have a two-on-two, so you could recover a loss.
I heard Shuffle used to be a magician.
And now he's your assistant? Well, after I'm done cutting this top, there won't be no reappearances when you get put in a box.
So, Dynamo, what's with the hair you're trying to grow? It's weird, since we've seen your career rise and float, but now we don't believe since we've seen the guys behind the ropes.
So it's time to put a stop to it, Star, because you ain't got any bars. But since your friend's into that magic and he slams rabbits in the slot of his ass, you're only convincing me that you use trickery to get to the top of the card.
You know why? Because you haven't got any bars. You play a comedy part, robbing the art, copying Minaj for a song in the charts. Honestly, Dad, I bet it's all posh in their parts. They're caught in a yard, probably laugh watching the economy starve.
All those animals you shot on your farm must make you feel like you live street. Ironic, you're only dunking the biscuit because you're rich, T.
You see where I'm from, all the teenagers are weed blazers. Where they're from, all the teenagers wear tweed blazers. I mean, this ain't a movie. will be seen, but you usually see me hold it down like Keith David. Whilst when it comes to youths and teens, you usually see these hold it down like keen rapists.
See us? We're Leeds' greatest. With street status you can't take away. I'll come to your village fair. You won't escape your fate.
And why is it in every battle you guys claim your mates?
Why?
You even know each other's birthdays. And I mean, I know that's your preferred taste, but me, I can't even pronounce Zen's first name.
No, bro. You make it hard for me to show love. Me and you were only friends because you tried robbing a place I was going to blow up.
Fam, Robert, why the fuck would I invite you to that cypher that you show up? You always try to go nuts. I swear it should come to blows, bro, but it already looks like somebody fucked your nose up.
Yo, that was cold, bruv. You better listen, don't make me turn this into freestyle time.
Oh, with you, it's always fucking freestyle.
What dialect? You know you can't leave me outshined. If it was up to him, we would have just done fucking three rounds, right? I have nothing in common with this guy.
Fuck you.
Nothing in common with this guy. On a wheel, except for the ends that we ran. Funny how they all think we're the frenemies, yet it's these two that needed a formula to get their chemistry set. Dialect and Zen. Who here's from out of town?
Yeah!
Right, you're us. Adam. £100.
£100?
Come on now, don't fuck about. We put money down.
For what?
You bet me Dialect would get his title shot before the month was out.
He has got his title shot.
This doesn't count! The fact that you've had to just stand and nod and accept this match, it's probably the most frank insulting you've ever had since the banker's offer was £7,000. The fucking doubles title? I bet if you'd been more patient, you could have had your shot of the better man. I'm just saying, you're only really here to narrow down the odds of who get the champ. Now your American fans are confused as shit because you've had to borrow a friend to clash.
Because you've had the options that Zen has lacked.
You're out the door this November.
And Jammer got you a separate clash.
It's like you're stacking blocks on a Jenga stand.
But he hasn't got very dexterous hands, so he's casually knocking them, sending crashing, and that's the problem with friends that rap.
No! Oh, yeah. No! The actual problem's your friend is crap. The actual problem's your friend is crap. You don't need his help to reach for your goal. You're Maradona, that extra hand is cannon fodder. You'd sever that. That would cause some massive awkward astronomical tension, lads. I mean, this pairing hasn't got an effective plan. It's catastrophic as Leningrad or crashing rockets in Dexter's lab. You said Zen's like a little brother. If that's still the case, you're Gilbert Grape. And that's an honourable gesture, man, giving up this time to sort your bros' needs. That gangster life you talk is phony, but you are like Michael Corleone, a man that's on a successful track whose family honour will set him back.
Let's go, baby!
Was that scheme a minute long?
Yeah.
What was the point?
Zen's the shit one?
Four words, that took. But look, we can see why you've got this title match. I mean, you beat Ricky C in Crisis Music. You lost to Bowski and Big Sars. What the fuck is going on? Huh? You two are not a proper team. There's no interactions when you split schemes. Your two on twos look like two separate battles on a split screen.
Let's go.
no proper team. There's no interactions when you split schemes. Your two and twos look like two separate battles on a split screen. Bowski and Sart has killed you, embarrassing you with ease. They deserve the shot to be the champions of this.
You tried it.
Fucking hell, that's actually true, though. You're both here based on individual merit. That's dialect alone. And it's teams that work as a team that should have the chance to wreck the throne. If we had a say, we'd rather Bowski and Sartas get a go. You two have been forced on us. Like when I last refreshed my phone. So who the fuck in here thinks this boy can take the belt? What, because you can flip your own boy and change it well so you can rebuttal something, but you need to employ some basic help, because what's the point in flipping a point when you don't have a point to make yourself? Last year, after we just beat C major, and his partner, the artist. And last year, after we just beat C major, and his partner, the artist formerly known as Dickhead. You won't believe the way Zen started pandering to me. Like, Marlo, how does it feel to be the champion, my G? You are the motherfucking man up here in Leeds. But you get it? I'd be so fucking gassed if it was me! Yeah. It's exactly because you're so hyperactive when you're keen that you'll never be the title holding battler in this league.
If they win today, that'll be a scene. Earth starts saying, the new don't flop 2-on-2 chat. He starts crapping in his jeans. And even when the official news hasn't been released, expect a status from Faris that'll read, this is actually a dream, with a link to We Are the Champions by Queen.
Please, stop asking to see the title chain. I know to you it has some massive appeal, but it's like I told you, it's a figure of speech. It's not actually real.
This battle means everything to Zen, because he's never felt as important as dialogue. If he loses...
If he loses today, it'll be too much to take. He'll mourn like a life was lost. And seeing us flips and predicting the end of our bars is all you're relying on. If you try predicting a bar at any point in this battle, it means you forfeit this title.
It's okay, it's just a joke.
This does mean a lot to you. So fuck Zen and dialect. They're never getting my respect. They're getting set and... Fuck Zen and dialect. They're never getting my respect. They're getting severed by the neck like Jebediah's head. And if Noel Edmonds tries to step... I'll have him dead at my request. Make him get a giant check and have it sent to my address. Call up the banker and tell him I accept. But he can get it too if he don't recognise the best. Sorry. When we get inside events, could you please pull down your hat? You have a very shiny head.
What is that?
Everyone shut up, because we've got a slogan now. They said, hey, Shufflow! Kill him with bars like you usually do. We said, I think you might have us confused with somebody else. They said, are you not unanimous in Chris Lee's? We said, no. They said, oh, are they here? We said, I don't know about Chris, but Yunan probably. He's battling Seoul tomorrow. Time!
Zen, hold on one second. Yo, can everyone come back?
Right.
Oh. I'm not gonna lie. They are good, aren't they? I mean, Subtlety and Marlo's jokes are hot. And I'm not gonna talk like I'm gonna hold the Glock. But on a real G, you are so shit, you just need to come back, hold and squat. Cause you know what I fucked up then? I seen his tea and I thought, geez, these geezers better beware. Cause you know it's always grease when I start bringing freeze to these pair. And I think to myself, I can shuffle tea and his tea here compare. Cause after I kill these motherfuckers, he'll be screaming bear. He said, all I'm ever doing is getting hyperactive, I'm not worth a title shot. But on a real, I'm calm right now. I ain't buzzing now. And then you said, it doesn't matter if we don't win, because this shit doesn't count. But I could still kill him in 12 bars and make a dozen count. See, today, we've come to beat you. so we can let you be funny people.
That's just banter.
We're about to make you look like Adam Sandler when he had the cancer. So you can try and win him off with bags of laughter. But me and Dialect, we're two contract killers here for a nominal fee. Not think we were gonna catch these bodies for free. You reached the top of the league. Tried filling your wallet with peas, but only get charity for being the comic relief.
Sick.
Your rap name used to be Kai. I'm gonna keep it kind of brief. We're in Leeds, so it's only right we see Kai's a chief.
I'm real talk, I ain't trying to mock your team, but why do you rhyme with this guy when his life's obsolete? He reminds me of the runt of the litter. Always hungry for dinner, but never quite got the tea. I mean, come on, fam, you do look depressed as fuck. You're just another lost civilian, and it's quite obvious you use comedy to block the images of feeling lost because your spot at the top is limited. But you need to stop the ignorance, because if you don't sort your life out before you've got the millions, your depression will have you resting in the same coffin that Robin's chilling in.
Marlo, is it true? Do you suffer from depression? Well, keep stressing, and soon enough you'll be needing a weave, brethren. Shuffle T was out on his estate looking for hair. Marlo was in a state looking for hair.
I mean, come on, fam, look at his hair. If you took more love and the caring to brushing your hair instead of just pushing it there. Wouldn't have had that fucking affair, and you, but ugly pair, would look like Sonny and Cher.
On a real, don't think we didn't come here prepared. And this pair better not doubt what I said, because it won't be no bald patch when I put a round in your head. Shuffle to your Marlo, dark cross around them dead. Who crowned them the best? You ain't nothing but clowns with a rep. Fuck an ounce of weed, what'd you know about an ounce of respect?
What do you know about travelling round for a set and try to stack pounds in the checks to make sure your daughter's mouth's getting fed? I mean, we do more than just hang around the events. So how would you a vet when you hardly come out of your ends like you're on housing arrest?
You know why? Because you ain't the best. So don't get deep with me, because things will get real gritty in the lead city. Don't be silly trying to beef with the 3 million it's grease until you see quickly see piggy quick free fiddy. I see your chicky. Get deep with me, cause things will get real gritty in Elite City. Don't be silly, tryna beef with the 3 million it's grease until you secretly see piggy quick free fiddy. Send your chick eat Willie, done a dance on stage. Been a beast to me recently, so don't think that he would have beaten me easily.
Easily, you have a beast for the Elite City streets for the man.
So don't get deep with me, cause things will get real gritty in Elite City. Don't be silly, tryna beef with the 3 million it's grease until you secretly see piggy's quick free fiddy. Send your chick eat when he done a dance on stage, but I get peed, did he? Mimi, been a beast to me recently, so don't think that he would have beaten me easily.
Easily, I'm a beast for the Elite City streets, so the man never agrees with your deep. You're living to be weak by your looks, your knees and your feet. With a hook, your body, you believe in your feet. I'm not shook, I've been squeezing the heat. If you push me, you're fucked and you bleed with your peeps. I'm a lyricist just like Weezy and D, but real talk feet to him, Z.
See me? Man, I'm a breezy with flow, so easy for folks. Think that a team is a job, won't blow your body, you believe in your core. I don't care about you. You're fucking your beef and your bros. Feeling good, but you keep it up caught to you deep in the mud like Nina Simone. So, you don't wanna get rowdy with Zen, rowdy with Death, start me out with the intro. You know when I get rowdy with Zen, rowdy with Death, bout me, you're out with your head, showering the set, dude, brown card on my rep, no, it didn't work.
Sounds of the best fit is coming out of the west down to ingest every single ounce of your flesh. Sounds are perfected. I got the crown of my head to know now that my whole style's out of your
deck. Bring out the sound of the death. Ooh. These nerves get serving the counter effect.
How could you test when you're looking down at the press around in my face? Could you keep hounding your ex?
Thinking you're posh when you're out with your becks. When I'm all four bars, like I'm counting a clef. Home for your drugs, house in a mess. I'll break you back in
the out with a mess.
we have to come here to Just Jam.
I want you to know, even though this two-on-two title might have come to hand, you will never play no part in this culture, fam. And it's funny how you look so much like Russell Brand. And it's funny how you look so much like Russell Brand and keep speaking on subjects you really don't understand.
Because whether you two think you're tough in the double, I guarantee you'll always change his tune when I put it on shuffle.
Yo. We're quite equal. And why were you guys clapping when they were doing that?
White people.
Last year we tore it up the stage, smashed it to two. This crowd knew from the jump the scene crack and we're through. Now you want a taste of what it's like to be the champions too? You don't want it, trust me.
Tell me.
Seriously. You don't want the doubles title. That is the truth. They make you do battles with food. Speaking of food.
Oh, yeah.
There's something we've got to drop if it's on our conscience.
We've got to expose this pussy scumbag for some proper bollocks.
Do you want to tell him? Do you? Go on. Tell them all what the interesting fact on your online official Deal or No Deal player profile says.
Marcus admits to having too much of a sweet tooth and loves scuffing chocolates.
Scuffy, woofy, chocolate. Interesting. Big bad gangster man with a tooth sweeter than castor grains. Mm. He'll blast away half your face if he's asked to wait till after eight for a... So why are you acting like you're all gully and such? The only shells you pop are the fucking gullion ones.
No. Your street. All quality.
Imagine Christmas Eve, and he's got his stockings up with his gifts on the mantle, his daughter all excited, sneaks in with a candle,
and sees her father dressed up as the Grinch with a satchel.
Mouth covered in chocolate like,
Christmas is cancelled.
I know what you're thinking. How dare he milk bars of this topic? About dairy milk bars and this topic. See, it's really weird just being here, watching him, wiping saliva from his lips, running low on oxygen. See, he just wants his chocolate fix. He wants to be scoffing it. He wants a whole box of it. Be ashamed if I were to start, oh, I don't know, dropping it. Stomp on it! Stomp on it! Now, I'll admit, what you did with that bar was a massacre. Come on, mate, this kid's starving in Africa. Joking with you about the mountain of sugar you eat. And we like that we can joke with you because we respect you so much because you're good for the league. I mean, you said a couple of bars over the years we couldn't believe, and I'm just... Sorry, I'm quite aware that your friend keeps looking at me. It's such a desperate you're a little fucking bear, it angers me. I've got a theory on the way that you attack the scene. See, you only take opponents on a downward streak. Let's take a look at your battle sheet. You had Censor after a bad defeat, Kun at the time he was catching heat for not being able to catch a beat, and, Bleak. See, the title trait will make a guy insane just to show he's got a hole. That's why Zen will never battle with an opponent on a roll. But if a battler's sucking, he'll snap him up like a photo of a pole, because it could be for him an easy win, and he's going for the goal. Football bars are shit. But if it's appropriate, I'm sold. Being a poacher is your role, that makes you closer to your goal. Question that you recently asked me.
What? Why does dialect always rap about genitalia?
Penises, largely. You're always referencing cocks when you're completing a bar scheme. You got dicks on their head like you fell asleep at a party. You said, I'm warring with a vet that's got a foreskin for a neck. Something about getting your hand on a baby's bell, that was as awkward as it gets. And by God, if you didn't say, I'm not talking about an erection when I say I keep my semi tucked. Pause it for effect. You really need to stop referencing guys' erections, mate. Because the word on everyone's lips is that dialect is gay. So if they become the champs, forgive me if I don't celebrate, because they'll be cocked lying to the top like a weather vane. When Bleak's dick technique, we laughed about that. Dialect was like, I'm going to write a bar about that. Oi, Zen, you set up to shit, mate. So disappointing, we forgot what the bar is. Your punches are boring. It's 4 when you started, then we clocked that it's 6:30. It's like telling your kids you're going to Disneyland, so they hop in the car quick, then saying, nah, I'm just joking, we're actually going shopping for carpets. And let me guess, Marcus, you brought your goons with you.
I knew
he would. Wait. Don't call him a bastard, all right? Back down. It's his nasty friends that are making him act out. I mean, he brings up those goons every time that he raps now, and it's not his fault he's falling in with a bad crowd.
Yeah. Marcus, truthfully, we gotta say, we think you're a pretty nifty dude. Gifted in the booth. But you have got to stop chilling with these
goons.
They are a bad influence on you.
I mean, Marky, look, I'd love to have you around for dinner, wouldn't I? I really would. But I just know that you'll bring your goons. And I do not need 15 dudes in shitty boots sprinting through my living room. Who's going to pay if they nip me spoons? And you might like having friends that'll kill for you, but one of these days, they could be killing you. Die in a hole, Zen!
Let's go, right. Final round, yeah?
Fuck these dudes. I enjoy chocolate and I like cookies too. I got bars like Charlie's Chocolate Factory and big rounds like Augustus Glue.
These guys are always gonna hurt on me. But I like to think some people in here think I'm a flossy.
Yeah!
They all think I've got shit setups until I build an explosive. Ooh.
You said 50 dudes sprinting through your living room? That ain't dinner, dude. That's a home invasion.
That weren't gonna happen, because you all know my floors are hot. And what I was meant to say at that point was, if I go and get my gun and blow the Glock, you'll get left stretched out like that first scheme in your first round slogan was. Check. See, this is banterous versus cantankerous. This battle ain't no war.
You do bad bars and magic, something a wizard's already known for.
For frauds, you would have thought it were Clone Wars, but this cold corpse holds no force like old Fords.
Wait, pause. You said you had a Fiesta from 83? That got you from A to B.
He never got to see his missus. She was always busy taking D.
That Polish bitch was on a date with me. So tell her next time she wants to make a scene, I'll pull out the Python and she'll get beat with the lights on.
That's KB.
But fuck it, that's make-believe. Cause you know what I'm on, and that's making beats. More than just blazing cheese and being that gangster you fake say I claim to be. When it comes to the music, there's not one fucking thing you could say to me. So if you don't think this brand kicks behind bars, you must be crazy, T.
So I suggest you start taking heed. Me and Dialect, we've been on it from Channel U. Now these battle dudes think that they can judge me for my attitude, but I bring a tool that'll blow out your back like a parachute.
Yeah, I'm a savage dude. Fuck a placid mood. I'll have Adam spazzing when I smack him out his Barrett shoes. Fuck trapping tools, I'd rather grab this dude than have him cabbaged in this massive room, and after I leave him black and blue, you'll see Clara ooze out of his bandage wounds.
On some real shit, a lot of these battle guys can't handle truth. But like, to be real, me and Dialect, we're not that gangster. And I doubt you two are this posh. But on the other hand, you are wankers, and we couldn't give a toss. Nice. I mean, win or loss, at least we don't have to stand on stage and act like you silly sods.
Ooh, sit and block, up all night to get your gimmicks locked.
But you're living lost, trying to give it locks like Tommy Villis blocks.
Wow. You see, battle rap was never about acting, but you guys made it that way. And I ain't saying it should change, but when Toucan came out, you claimed you were gay. I guess you were just proving that Toucan play at that game.
We all get our 15 minutes of fame. The only question is whether you'll ignore your pride for the other 45. Now they've come for hours, and I ain't talking time.
So why throw up these West Yorkshire signs to rep for the city that formed my rise? So why you talking shy? Cause if the doc can't get your jaw aligned, I love this cunt talking like the son of Walter White.
We'll be the first to admit you've had an enormous rise. But the fact of the matter is, here's where our career progresses and yours declines. Fuck with us until the judge gets some auto rise. But I brought a knife to all the guys that forceful bride.
No, fam, why are you talking like these two ain't the greats? I mean, look at all of the views that they gained from all of the music they made. I mean, have you even been a king of the dot, fam?
You what?
King of the dot.
Oh, wait. He's on about the time these two tried making moves in the States.
Yeah,
you know when Shuffle T pulled out that peace treaty and got super enraged because these city dickheads nearly got booed off the stage? Don't stop and King of the Docks. You tried making the two of us mates. Even brought a peace treaty because you wanted proof of the names. They looked you straight in your face and screwed up the page. You gave him a paper plane. It's only right you threw it away. Even if we lose this today, me and Dialect, bro, we ain't fretting inside.
Nah.
Cause you'll just be remembered as guys who were the best at the time until Er and the rest of Don't Flop left them behind. Kinda like that peace treaty that never got signed. I love you dissing us going to America in the title match. Yeah, they hated it. That's why we were invited back. And really, Toucan play at that game? That was the line that you kept?
Bad bars.
No, honestly, I liked it the first time it was said. By Anton Murphy.
I don't watch his battles, innit? Allow me, man.
Zen! I'm confused. Yeah, you're such a fucking
tough guy. Why don't you fucking punch me? I've never seen you punch anyone. See, he'd like to punch me, but I don't think that he knows how. He'd like to shoot his fist at my cheekbone now. You can't even come through with some kung fu to make me go down, but fuck you. I'll punch someone like Theo.
I'm sorry.
But look, he may make you think like you hit you, like he hit you, but you never punch with your fist.
You lot would have more chance seeing dialect with that gun at his hips that doesn't exist. Because you bring those guns out in battles, then it's always one your goon busts. You're a fake G, you do nothing but prove others are true thugs, but you? You're worse because you look up to this huge cunt. You're in the shadow of that G like the intro to Goosebumps. Yeah. Look at me when I'm killing you! Look at him! You think we fucking like pretending to be nice all of the time? That kind of shit is really fucking boring to write.
Fuck this shit! Forget Morecambe and Wise's time, all of you guys saw our less employable side.
Dialect. This is about to be
so real.
We saw your girl on a game show.
No deal!
And the weird thing is, most battle rappers are massively punching above their weight. I fucking know I am. And despite his ugly face, Shuffle's dating a couple eights. Most prob, Enigma, everyone's got a lucky steak. Yulan does all right if he's made a lovely cake.
Fingers Kruger's soul keeps coming, it's just worse. I'm sure to your baby mother this must hurt.
But you're not punching above your weight.
She's punching above hers. Oh! Real talk? You're not a bad looking guy. No, I don't care. You're so good looking, you could be an extra member and take that. You're so good looking, my mum thinks you're hot and she normally hates.
Seriously though, your woman, totally harsh face.
Our advice, leave her alone in a dark place.
A more pitiful look than a homeless guitar case.
She's a trophy wife, that's a trophy for last place.
And I'm sick of seeing all your fucking emo statuses updating us on what your fucking emo status is. One recently just said, grown man tears. Oh. Exactly right, that shit made me grown man cheers. I really want to make sure that this isn't an understatement. If you're one of these pillocks that runs to Facebook to post an ambiguous public status with a ridiculous fucking statement that essentially begs people to ask what it actually is that you're fucking saying, like,
some people never learn,
or
gonna be thinking of someone later,
or
just when you think things are going right, the thing that you love is taken.
Kill yourself! Be like Big J and use the private message more, because you are everything wrong with this attention-seeking life the web has forged, and one of the worst cases I see online dialect is yours. Anyway, rant over.
No, I'd like to vent some more. Yeah. Now, whether it's about spitting freeze with Ricky C or how you're on a killing spree, I've got to stop hearing you brag about your own ability. Like, salesmen at a business meet showing off they hit this week's target, that shit is weak and it just doesn't sit with me. Get rid of that big head before I remove it with the guillotine. There is a reason him and me don't show off on our Twitter feed. Arrogance is characters. In battles you can blow smoke about yourself like nicotine, but fuck doing it outside of it, have some fucking dignity. If you're respected in this scene, here in Leeds, is let the stats and then the facts say they rate you lyrically. Mm. Don't go on Facebook claiming you're God's gift to me. It's not your fucking place to say. Have some fucking humility. Mm. And just because you went on Deal or No Deal and didn't only come up with 5p doesn't mean you haven't quit as a runner at Sky yet. And stop bitching behind people's backs about the money you'd like, Zen. Maybe if you actually wrote instead of just rebuttaling lines, then you could chuck in a price next. High rise sounds like a clothing line in peacocks. Shut up and die, Zen. Your best battle is bleak and your face is as ugly as my head. We can dodge your best punches with a couple of sidesteps, because we're those motherfuckers.
The Chuckle Brothers.
It's a fuck up your groin, Zen. The lanky weird champs are here. You are not a proper team. Only one of you has a rap career. You don't even write together. That is clear, it's cavalier. Whereas our prep game is Southwest trains for 3 hours, then praying we can crank the gears and make a clash appear. And when we write this shit, it's a whole different atmosphere. When we have ideas, it's not a light bulb that appears, it's a chandelier. Fucking clap and cheer the fans in here and hand out free shit like here. Have a beer. How old are you? You're 19, get out of here. Best numbers in the country. Whatever, but that's true. Cheers. All we know is we climbed this mountain here and we bought our fucking camping gear.
That sounds gay, it's not gay.
Let's fucking go,
Tom. Yo, Yunnan, fresh off watching that, Shuffle Team Marlo vs Dialect and Zen battle. I just want to say that was insane. That's one of the best rap battles I've seen live in a long, long time. That was insane. I wanted to do it like properly and not just do it on like, you know, overall. I thought it is a title match, so I should break it down by rounds. I had Shuffle Team Marlo winning the first round. Zen and Dialect won the second round. But that double time shit, I know people might say it's irrelevant and all this, but it ain't gotta be personal, bro. That was executed fucking ridiculously. That was, if you could find me 10 rappers in Don't Flop that could do that, I'll pay you money. That was insane. That was fucking insane. And then I had, you know, Zen and Dialect's third round. It just wasn't at the caliber that Shuffle T and Marlo's was at all, man. I fuck with Zen and Dialect heavy. Go check my battle with Dialect. It's a fucking classic. But I've got to say that I feel like Shuffle T and Marlo won that 2-1.
Yo, man. Heated battle. Crazy, man. Fucking Dialect is my motherfucking bruv, man. I've never seen Zen before. Zen is dope. His rebuttals, his freestyle is crazy. I'm already a fan of Marlo and Shuffle, you know what I'm saying? I've been a fan of them dudes, been following them since before Marv and the Quest match, man. It's first round, Marlo and Shuffle. Second round, I gave to Dialect and Zen. As much as I want to give it to Dialect and Zen, man, they really did their motherfucking thing. Punches, freestyle, everything. They was well-rounded. But them Shuffle and Marlo, man, is... I don't see too many people beat them dudes, man. Yo, shout outs to Shuffle and Marlo, man. I got them too, man. 2-1.
G-PS5 out here judging Marlo and Shuffle T versus Dialect and Zen. This is a close battle. I'm not even going to judge it on rounds. Overall, I thought they've been getting at each other, but, you know, one thing has stood out for me above and beyond everything else. This is the dynamic and teamwork of Marlo and Shuffle T. It's just shitting on what Dialect and Zen are doing. And they mentioned it in there and I thought it hit. I thought Dialect and Zen went off, you know, dissing each other on the first round. I don't think that's effective. I thought that was a waste of time, took away from momentum. You don't want to be doing that. I think Shuffle T and Marlo had a couple times when they did it, but nowhere near to the extent of Dialect and Zen. And I thought overall, it's just the teamwork and how well they're getting across what they're doing. It's slicker. You know, I like the freestyles that Zen's coming with, but overall, bar for bar, execution over time, I'm going to have to give that to Marlo and Shuffle T, which I weren't quite expecting at the beginning to be real, but anyway, bless.
Well, that was a fucking tough call. I'll just get right into it. I feel like Dialect and Zen had a really clever opening where they did the whole sarcasm, like pointed out. That was like a really good preemptive strike. And also they had like a lot of dialogue incorporated into their first. I feel like that took a lot away from Shuffle T and Marlo going on about, oh, it's like watching a split screen and you don't even write together and stuff. So I think they played it really well in the first round in that sense. I had Shuffle T and Marlo like a little bit heavier on the punches, but I called the first round even because of that, and also Shuffle T a minor slip. The second round, I think that was like brilliantly executed by the home team. I think like people would expect them to be like they can quote unquote rap better, but what they did is they turned their rapping ability into a gimmick. And I think that's showmanship. They like they countered Marlo and Shuffle's like advantage on the showmanship part, and that was brilliant. Like, I'll be honest, like most of the time when they were rapping that fast, I didn't even catch it, but like obviously it works. So like, I don't even care what they were saying. Like, you know, if it wasn't in England, it might not have worked, even maybe if it wasn't in Leeds, but it was tonight in Leeds. They're the home team. It was the perfect thing to do, and I don't know how well it's going to translate on camera, but like the vibe was crazy. So yeah, that was like the moment of the match. I think like even though Marlo and Shuffle are brilliant, I think I just might have to give like a slight edge to Dialect and Zen because of that. Also, I think Zen's rebuttals at the beginning of the third were great. Also, the doesn't count earlier on, and I think that people were kind of a little bit worried that Zen might be boxing above his weight class. So to me, it felt like this was his big moment. Like, he really rose to the occasion, and yeah, he did really, really well. And I think his rebuttals kind of might have edged it towards Dialect and Zen. Also, I feel like Shuffle T and Marlo, their characters work really, really well when they're like clowning people and being sarcastic. Like, the Christmas is canceled shit was brilliant. But that same persona is not as good when you want to be like sincerely judgmental. Like, when they start telling people what to do with their lives and putting people down, and it feels like they're being sincere. It's like, Then it would be better with a different persona, not the posh guy coming in and telling you how to live your life. Like, it doesn't work as well as the clowning stuff. But I think both teams did brilliant. Marlo had like a little problems getting going after one reaction. That was also like, when it's so close, you just gotta count it in. So actually, I'll give it to the home team, man.
Yeah, man, that was a crazy battle, 2-on-2. Dialect and Zen versus Marlo and Shuffle T. That's probably one of the best 2-on-2s I've seen. Round by round, I like Dialect and Zen's first round, but I actually think this battle really came to who went second because it was unlimited. So if I had to choose, I know Marlo and Shuffle T, one of them stumbled in the first, but I still feel like their first was strong enough to get that round. Round two, hands down, Dialect and Zen, the back and forth, double time, the grime, that was the craziest shit I ever seen, back and forth with two different people, so I definitely gave them that round. And then I feel like Dialect and Zen, they were strong in the third at the beginning, but they kind of died off at the end. And Marlo and Shuffle T, that last part when they said, a bright idea to you is a light bulb, to me it's a chandelier, that was crazy. So I'm gonna have to edge it to Marlo and Shuffle T. I think they definitely edged that battle, but I think it was a good battle.
Sleepy G just judged the title match, don't know how. I gave pretty much every round to Shuffle and Marlo, man. I thought every single round, Dialect and Zen, their rounds were the way they were, the best way to do it, but every single round, Shuffle and Marlo hit back harder. Like, sorry for the not very breakdowny thing, but I got to leave.
All right, bomb. Twisted Pennies, BLG, Leicester City, all of that. Just watch Shuffle T and Marlo versus Dialect and Zen. Obviously, when people say it's hard to judge battles, this is the first battle I've ever judged and like the third event I've ever been to. You know, I'm just in the deep end and shit, but that's nothing. Obviously, I just have to hold it down. Shuffle T and Marlo definitely made me laugh a lot more, like, as usual. Like, it's just like, oh, how did you even, like, that's just, what the fuck, you know what I'm saying? But rap-wise, I give it Dialect and Zen because that thing about the fucking the goons at dinner, that made me laugh, like, a lot. But then Zen's bar about the home invasion, that kind of cancels it out because it just, you know what I'm saying? But, yeah, that's definitely the best performance I've ever seen from Zen, and obviously Dialect held it down, and they came more of like a calm angle. Obviously, they did the whole grind thing where they just went back to back with the rapid fire thing for a while, and I think that was key in their success because that's them showing them in their element on this kind of platform. And yeah, I give it to them just rap wise, you know what I'm saying? But Shuffle T and Marlo, obviously, it's like they can't, you know, like fuck off, innit? Like, you can't fucking fuck with them, you know what I'm saying? But for rap value, I give it to Dialect and Zen. Comedy-wise and entertainment, Shuffle T and Marlo, it's a rap thing, so overall, Dialect and Zen.
Cool. Oh, this is boy, 6th birthday. Don't flop all fucking day, you know the score. It was Shuffle T and Marlo, it was Dialect and Zen. The final battle on day one. Please make some noise for the 4 MCs. Let's go! Yes, you know the score. As always, at the end of the video, please make sure you click through onto our official website and vote for who you think won. This was a judge battle, the only judge battle of the day. It was a 5-2 split decision. But the team picking up the win and still the fucking champion.
Mate, this time, cause your talk is cheap. So I won't give you no cash you can spend for battling at this event. It'll just give your memory bank and Mr. Reality check.